What I'll quickly do is just spend about 5 to 7 minutes and then we'll adjourn. Just on Bayesian estimation, I wanted to introduce to you. The idea is extremely straightforward, and always straightforward ideas will have very complicated implementations, generally speaking. I remember my brother used to say, if the question is a one-liner, then you are doomed. That means you have to really supply the information and write a long answer. If the question is very long, then you are happy because there is a lot of information. So likewise here, the idea in Bayesian is extremely straightforward. There is only a single equation, and that equation stems from Bayes' rule. But the implementation and the philosophy is not simple. The Bayesian estimators depend on a very, very important and different philosophy that's in fact different from all the three estimators that we have discussed: method of moments, least squares, and MLE, right? The assumption here in the Bayesian philosophy, which many people do not like or subscribe to, is that parameters that you are estimating are random, they are not deterministic. So imagine if I were to say, estimate the mean of a Gaussian white noise process, and I tell you the mean is also a random variable. You may not like it so much. How can the mean be a random variable? It's a statistical property. I have been thinking all along that it's a fixed quantity, and now suddenly somebody comes along and says it's random. So that kind of puts off many people when it comes to Bayesian. But you just have to relax, you just have to hold on, don't get so agitated about this assumption. What it says essentially is, it is not necessarily that the true parameter is random. It appears to be random because of our uncertainty. That is how you look at Bayesian, and then you are at ease with this philosophy. Otherwise, you will constantly be agitated and be engaged in endless debates. All you have to tell yourself is, the truth may not be random, but the mask that I am wearing, which I am unable to throw off, makes the truth uncertain. That means I always have some uncertainty shrouding the truth. Bayesian philosophy says, why don't you consider the truth along with the uncertainty that you have put together? And that is why it says, you begin with an uncertainty about the truth. What we mean by begin is before data, BD, before data and after data. Before data, you have uncertainty in the truth, your knowledge, and after data also you will remain uncertain. Your data is only going to help you shrink the uncertainty, but it will never take it to zero, because you can never estimate the truth with certainty. That is the basic idea, and that is why there is this concept of prior and posterior in Bayesian. Prior is before you perform your experiment. So suppose I were to ask you, what is the average temperature in this room? You may give me some value, but obviously you are not going to be certain about it. You say, well, there is some uncertainty around it. Then you perform an experiment, right? If there is a sensor somewhere, you bring a temperature sensor, measure, collect data, and now the purpose of collecting data, what is the purpose? To get more precise estimate, to come up with a more precise estimate. What Bayesian philosophy does is, very beautifully, very nicely, allows you to fuse two different pieces of information. One information is your own prior knowledge, prior guess, whatever you may want to call, and the other piece of information is data. So you have prior information, you have data, you have to really marry them very well, so that what comes out is a more precise estimate of the average. Until now, we have not talked about prior at all. Whether it's maximum likelihood or least squares or method of moments, we have pretended I don't know anything. I have no idea what the average temperature is. Is that the case? Really? In many applications, I will have some idea. You don't know anything? It is not true. You will have some idea about the estimate. Sometimes you may not, but which is okay. In Bayesian method, that is also possible. If you say that I don't know much about this thing, I don't have a good knowledge, initial guess of the theta, that is also okay. You can actually incorporate that information. So, prior to the experiment, we have a large uncertainty, typically in parameters, and post experiment, and through proper data analysis, hopefully that uncertainty has shrunk. And you should conduct, this also tells you what kind of experiments you want to perform. You should conduct experiments that will reduce uncertainty in your prior. That means don't get some data which has no information. We have already talked about Fisher's information. So everything comes about very nicely. So the only equation that governs the Bayesian estimation philosophy is this single equation. The single equation stems from Bayes' rule. Now that we have assumed theta to be random, we already know measurements are random. Therefore, we can say the joint PDF of the observations and theta. Now theta is also random. So I have to now consider the PDF, joint PDF of the observations and the parameters. This joint PDF we know from Bayes' rule, f of x comma y, what is it? It is f of x given y times f of y, of course marginal, right? So I can write this as f of y given theta times f of theta. It is understood that this is marginal. This is one way of writing it. Am I right? What is the other way of writing this joint PDF? F of theta given y. So this is also equal to f of theta given y times f of y. Again, this is a marginal. So this is, these identities are the ones that are being written. This identity is the one that has been written there for you. Now we can throw away this. What am I interested in? What do I know? Right? First of all, what is f of theta? F of theta is a PDF of your parameters prior. Is that, it is the prior before you begin your experiment. That means no data is given to you. Absolutely no data is, regardless of the experiment that you are going to perform, you have some knowledge of theta. That is your f of theta. It is knowledge with some uncertainty. Say, therefore, this is a prior. What is f of y? That is the joint PDF of your observations, right? So this is your coming from your experiment. Now that in fact this is just f of y independent of theta. You can see that because it is marginal, regardless of the theta, that is f of y. What is this here? You have seen this before. That is a likelihood. That is the measurement that you are assuming, you are now parameterizing. That is, now the difference between f of y and f of y given theta is, this f of y is a marginal, it has got nothing to do with theta. It is some fixed value as far as the moment I freeze y, the moment I freeze the data, f of y n is fixed. Whatever may be the theta, f of y is fixed. Whereas this here is a PDF of y conditioned on theta. It depends on the value of theta that you assume. It is nothing but your observation PDF that you have assumed. That is coming from the user. So you have to supply this. We are anyway doing this in MLE, right? For in the previous example, this was a joint Gaussian. So this is your likelihood. In fact, you can say L of theta given y, but I am just going to write L. So this is likelihood. Then you have prior, and then this is what you are looking for. When before you begin the experiment, you have f of theta. After you have conducted the experiment, you want to ask what is the uncertainty in theta given this data. So look at this carefully. Before you begin the experiment, you have some guess of theta. Like you say, the average temperature here is 20 degrees Celsius. With some, let's say, Gaussian distribution, Gaussian kind of uncertainty, whatever uncertainty it may have. Now you bring in a sensor, you get the readings, and you say, now given these readings, what is your estimate, what is the uncertainty of your estimate? That is f of theta given y, which is what we want to calculate. This is therefore the posterior after the experiment has been conducted. This is before the experiment, and that is why you have the equation f of theta given y is f of y given theta times f of theta divided by f of y. But we have already said the denominator is independent of theta in that equation that you see on the screen in equation 20 there, the denominator is independent of theta. So, I can assume it to be some constant. F is a scalar, f of y n is a scalar value. So, it is some constant that is independent of theta. Now, what Bayesian estimation does is, it says this is your posterior. It gives you everything, whatever you wanted about theta after the experiment. What do you mean by everything? What we mean by everything is, whatever we wanted out of an estimation exercise. What did we do with MLE or least squares and so on? We first constructed point estimates, and then we went through the pain of deriving the distribution of that point estimates. All of that is captured in the single f of theta given y. It is straight away giving you the interval of possibilities along with the distribution. Now, you can derive whatever you want to do with this f of theta given y. You can say, f of theta given y is too much for me to work with. I need to provide a single estimate to the user. I need to provide a point estimate. So, situation is reverse here. There we first derive point estimate and then derive interval estimates. Here straight away I give the interval estimates. These are called set estimators. You derive point estimators. What we mean by you derive point estimators is, suppose I give you the PDF of a random variable. What are the things of interest to us when I look at the PDF of a random variable? Mean, variance, or mode, or median, and so on. So, if I were to ask you, I give you the PDF of a random variable and I ask you to find out a single number that represents the outcomes. We have talked about this early on, mean, median, mode. Bayesian estimation essentially works on the same idea. First, I give you f of theta given y. I give you the main piece of information. From there, it is up to you. You can derive the mean of this and say that is one point estimate. What would be the mean of, what do you mean by expectation of f of theta given y? What would be that? That is nothing but your conditional expectation of theta given y. What is conditional expectation? It is a best prediction. So, you see the Bayesian estimation is giving you the minimum mean square error prediction. That is, given f of theta, if I have f of theta given y, I can calculate expectation of theta given y. How do I calculate this? Integral, what is the expression at least, theoretical expression? That is it. So, theta f of theta given y d theta. Right. So, given f of theta given y, that is once I compute f of theta given y, I can straight away calculate the conditional expectation. The conditional expectation is the best estimate of theta. Best in what sense? Minimum mean square error sense. This will get you minimum mean square error estimate. Earlier that something we could not achieve. We said, oh, I cannot solve an MMSE problem because I do not know the truth. Bayesian estimation does that for you. What we will do tomorrow is, we will quickly go through an example on Bayesian estimation and then scan through the estimation of signal properties, namely ACF and spectral densities, and then day after we will look at estimating time series models. Okay.